Yo, what is up, my beautiful people? This is a big video for us Blackwing players because it is changing a lot, bro. It is changing a lot for our future. Because I remember, man, when I said that Kyuga was dead and gone and I was finished playing it, I thought it's not competitive anymore. It was until this day because I completely took this whole deck apart and reconstructed it and made it now even better than ever before. Which I believe it is, because I added some spice to this deck that you're not going to see right now. People on Patreon already have this weeks ago, so if you want to be updated, make sure to follow me on Patreon, also for the deck lists. And yeah, but today I'm going to show you only one Simoon line, just to show you guys my vision, what I'm working on right now. And oh my goodness, this is I'm really excited to show you this, guys, because I'm actually, like, you guys know I hated playing Kyuga, right? You guys know that. I was a more fan of playing a pure version with Horrors or with Bastards, because it was just more consistent in my opinion. And the lines weren't that difficult, because the thing is with the Kyuga build, with the past Kyuga build, I'm not talking about the Dark Arm line, because Dark Arm was really easy and simple. But even that had his issues and weaknesses. But this right now doesn't really have any weaknesses. And I'm going to explain and show you guys that in a minute. My issue with the past Kyuga build, which we were used to play Steam and Rank Up and Raider's Ring, was that once we hard drew Raider's Ring, Steam, or the Rank Up, it didn't mean that we bricked, but we had to change our line completely, and then we were actually vulnerable against hand traps like Imperm, hand traps like Nibiru, whatsoever, once we hard drew one of those cards, right? But now, you're going to love this. You're going to love this one. All right, let's jump into this. Okay, so in this deck, for example, you can have, we are playing two, you know, they're not necessarily bricks, because you can hard draw them, and it might even be better for us, because then we are going to play easier through hand traps. But it doesn't really change your line at all. The lines are always staying the same. It doesn't matter what cards you draw. And this is one of my biggest issues that I had in the past, is that you need to be more creative and improvise with all those lines, right? Now you don't have to be. Now you don't have to. Don't worry about anything anymore, because the lines are always the same. All right. So we're starting here with Simoon, okay? This also works with Zudri Walter, Zudri Shamal, Zudri Whirlwind, Zudri Blackfeather Whirlwind, Shamal and Walter. So this basically works with every other two-card combo that was also possible with the past Kyuga build. In addition, it even has one or two more two-card combo lines that I'm going to show you. Alright, so we're going to add Zudri here, okay? Normal summon. And the cool thing about here is that even if you get impermed wherever, like, you're not really going into minus. You're just going to keep rolling. Okay, so we're going to add this. Activate Vata's effect. Like, it looks like we are just doing the normal synchronized, which is like the good thing, because we are tricking our opponent in that we are actually playing the pure version, even though we are not playing the pure version. Okay, so here, it's up to you if you want to add Hamatan or Chinook to your hand. You can add both. Only difference is that you're gonna end up on a full armor master if you have Hamatan. If you do not want to end up on a full armor master, rather have Chinook, then you will end up on Boreal Storm. But that's the only difference. You have to, okay. Alright. And then Walter is going to be special summoned. Now we can use these two to go into Boreal Storm. And the cool thing is here, in the past we used to send Steam, which I really disliked, because we are now playing Shanga, right? And with Shanga in the graveyard, it's better than anything else. You always want to have this card in the graveyard. Alright, so next up, we can use these two to go into this pattern. Okay, and The cool thing is, like, we can get nipped here the whole time. As long as Zephyros is in the graveyard, we are fine, okay? Now, Special Summon Hammerton. Go into White Strix. Special Summon Level 4 monster. Now, we're going to activate this pad as effective. Special Summon another Level 4 monster, which is banished. Usually, Shamal is banished. Otherwise, if there's no other Level 4 access, you can just bounce the Black Feather Wyvern with Zephyros and summon Zephyros. Alright, now we can go here to Raider's Knight. And this is one thing that I really like, is we are going to use Raider's Knight to build our Kali Yuga, which is really cool, because now with the addition of Raider's Knight, we can also play Arcribank Seize Dragon to OTK easier going second. So that's already one reason why I really like this deck. Now we're going to activate Raider's Knight's effect. Summon the Brave Strix. Okay, now we got the Brave Strix. And then Wild Strix will trigger and we can set one of our rank ups. And this is going to be the magic launch. Okay, I'm going to show you that in a minute. Yep. And then we can activate Brave Strix effect to add the other rank up. And this rank up right here, bro, is insane. First of all, it is going to summon Azure Falcon on Brave Strix. In addition, this card has a second effect, is that the next turn, the card on the turn where this where you didn't activate the first effect, you can just banish during your main phase, except the turn this card was sent to the graveyard. You can banish this card and one Rate Raptor monster from your graveyard, then target one Rate Raptor Xyz monster in your graveyard, special summon it. So basically, if our big ultimate Falcon gets tributed or destroyed, next turn we can just special summon it right back, and that is insane. All right, so we're gonna activate that, summon our Azure Falcon, and then boom, summon Shamal. Next up, we're gonna use all of those four monsters to summon the Darkness Meldragon. Why the Darkness Meldragon is because, first of all, we want to send the Azure Falcon to the graveyard. In addition, this card also gives us a lot of grind game. So every turn we can special summon a monster, which is really nice. And once that monster leaves the field, it's going to be recycled back to our X deck or main deck, which is really cool. Okay, so we also have more grind game. Alright. Now as a Falcon triggers and boom, we're gonna summon the ultimate Falcon. And now the cool thing is that we can activate the ultimate Falcon's effect, okay? And now, until the end of this turn, our opponent cannot activate any monster effects ever again. Until the end of this turn. So what that means is, if he Nibiru does right there, it's fine, because we still got Zephyros, so we can still play. But usually, what you guys also had the issue with is that sometimes our opponent, if he's smart, he just keeps Imperm Nibiru until the end of the phase and then boom, destroys everything, right? We're not gonna have that issue anymore. Right now is the last chance for our opponent to use Nibiru. If he does, it's cool. If he doesn't, it's GG. Why? Because now we're gonna continue with activating Zephyr's effect, summon him, reactivate the Black Feather Wyvern, now banish your Blackwing Dragon and your Boreal Storm from your graveyard, and then summon the Assault Dragon. Trigger the Black Feather Wyvern and summon right back your Boreal Storm. And this is what I'm saying, like, if you, for example, added now Hammerton as Chinook instead of Hammerton, you would have one Zephyros less. So you would have another interruption with Chinook on your hand, which is cool, but you wouldn't be able to summon full Armor Master. Okay, so you gotta decide, either it's Armor Master or Chinook on your hand. And now, for the Kali Yuga finish, you're going to activate Darkness Meldrum's effect. Summon Azure Falcon. And this is basically it. Look at this insane walk, guys. First of all, Super Poly is not going to be an issue anymore. Because, alright, cool. He's going to Super Poly our Azure Falcon and probably our Dispata. Cool. We still have two big towers, Assault Dragon, Shanga in the graveyard. And if we do not start with only one Simoon, we might even have Chinook in our hand, which is enough. You don't need more or less. All right, and the cool thing about this is that This deck is not losing to the barrier. If you didn't understand why, make sure to follow me on Patreon or be patient and stay tuned here on YouTube until I show you what I mean by that. Okay, so here, by activating the rank up, you can just summon Kalyuga. Boom, like that. I mean, look at the sport, bro. Look at the sport. This is crazy. This shit right there is crazy, bro. And this is... You guys might not understand right now what this actually means to us. This is more than you can process. Because... Bro. What if I tell you that now, with one Simoon, through the barrier, through the shifter, and through infinite impermanence, through those three cards, we can still summon Kalyuga. If you don't know what I mean, make sure to follow me on Patreon. But we can now, and this is why I like this deck so much. Right, yeah, I'm really excited, man. I'm really excited. I believe that this is right now the most competitive play, because I tested it a lot against my people, and my people know exactly how to play now or counter Blackwings, and they're struggling right now to play against me. So this is the way. I'm going to take this for the next regionals YCS. So stay tuned for the results. All right. Thank you guys for watching. I love you all. Take care. Bye-bye.